Want to know how to recognize functional groups in organic compounds? You've come to the right place. This is part two of a three-part series. Hi, I'm Dr. K, and welcome to ChemSimplified. In this video, we'll explore alcohol, ether, and amines using some examples. I've posted a video on the introduction to the 13 functional groups. I'll leave a link on the top as well as in the description box below. Do check it out to get more info on how to differentiate and remember each of these groups. We'll start with the first group in this series, which is alcohol. Alcohol has a hydroxyl group, which is OH. In recognizing alcohol, you look for the presence of OH in the structure. So the first structure, we have OH right here. And in the second structure, we actually have two OHs. And in the third structure, there's one OH right there. The first structure, the one on the left, is actually an expanded formula. The structure in the center is a condensed formula. And the structure on the right-hand side is a bond line formula. You can get more info on these types of structural formulas in part one of this series. Sometimes you may be required to classify the type of alcohol that you have, and you can do so by looking at the carbon, which is directly connected to the OH. So let's look at the first structure. The first structure, that carbon is connected to one carbon and two hydrogens, and that makes it a primary alcohol. Now let's look at the center, the second structure. The second structure, either one of the OHs, just look at it. That carbon that's directly connected to the OH group is connected to two carbons and one hydrogen. So two carbons, that makes it a secondary alcohol. And last but not least, the third structure, the carbon that is connected to OH, that carbon is connected to three other carbons. No hydrogen, just three carbons. So three, that's a tertiary. So you have a primary alcohol on the first structure, secondary in the center, and tertiary on the third. Moving on, we have ether, which is not to be confused with ester. Ether has a functional group where you have an oxygen in the center and it's sandwiched between two carbons. So in identifying ether, what we do is we look for compounds that has oxygen and we look at the atoms that's connected to that oxygen. If the two atoms that are connected directly to that oxygen, there are both carbons, that is a representation of ether. So right here in the first compound, we have oxygen sandwiched between two carbons. In the second structure, same thing, oxygen sandwiched between two carbons. And same thing again, on the third structure, you have oxygen sandwiched between two carbons. Last but not least, we have amines, and also not to be confused with amide. Amine is a nitrogen-containing compound. That nitrogen has three single bonds. An important fact to remember is that nitrogen in amine has to be connected to at least one carbon. Otherwise, if the nitrogen is connected to three hydrogens, that's actually called an ammonia. It's not an amine. Let's look through the three examples that we have. So we have our amino group here, our N right there in this compound. And that's our N again in the second compound. And that's our N again in our third compound. So notice all of these N's has three single bonds. So let's look at the first structure, the one on the left. Notice that that nitrogen is connected to one carbon and two hydrogens. So we can actually classify the amine and we can classify as primary amine because that nitrogen is connected to only one carbon. And now let's look at the second amine. It's a secondary amine because that nitrogen is now connected to two carbons and one hydrogen. So that's a secondary amine. So now let's look at the third example. So in the third example, we have nitrogen, and all three single bonds that are connected to our nitrogen are connected to carbons. So that's a tertiary amine. And that's all we have on this series. Definitely do check out the other two parts in this series if you haven't done so yet. If you enjoy this video and feel that it is helpful in showing you how to recognize the alcohol, ether, and amine groups, share it with your friends or anyone you think might benefit from it. Also, do subscribe and click on that bell icon so you'll get notified on new videos. For more info or practice questions, please head over to ChemSimplified.com. I'll post the blog link in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.